variable area flow meters. Now if you see here, it has the inlet, outlet, the body, and the most important thing is the float to it. So the symbol will also follow the same logic to it. So first let us make the body, and then the important thing is the float in between. So this is your P&ID symbol as per ISA 5.1 for variable area flow meters. The next symbol is for a very important flow meter, which is Coriolis flow meter. The flow meter body is something like this. Now let us try to understand what smart ways have been used to represent this particular flow meter. So there are tubes inside. The tubes vibrate, they oscillate, and the more they are out of phase, the more higher is the flow. So ISA 5.1 has done something amazing. What they did was, they tried to mimic this working concept in their symbol. If you see here, the tubes are represented something like this, and the body is represented here. So this is your Coriolis P&ID symbol. Now let us look at magnetic flow meters. Magnetic flow meters are very similar to Superman. So how do you have an S in the Superman, which is most important thing? Similarly, for a magnetic flow meter, the M here is very important. So the magnetic flow meter P&ID symbol is sometimes shown as an M inside a box, which stands for magnetic flow meters. Also, ISA 5.1 has another symbol to it. Because the construction is of magnetic woundings together, this symbol is shown something like this, where the things inside the box represent nothing but the magnetic coils. Next important thing is positive displacement flow meters. So this positive displacement flow meter looks something like this, with the vanes here put. So this is represented like this. Remember here one important thing, that the vanes are shown in the horizontal plane. So this symbol is for the P&ID symbol for positive displacement flow meter. Now we look at the symbol for a turbine flow meter, which is very similar to it. So for a turbine flow meter, if you see, the working construction is very simple. There is flow, and that flow causes the turbine blades to move, and once the blades move, there is the magnet which has to be collected by the magnetic pickup coil. So the more rotations happen, the more is the flow, and the more pickup coil represents the signals coming to it, which shows that the flow keeps increasing as the turbine blades move faster. As the flow reduces, the turbine blades would move slower. Now, so the most important thing in the turbine flow meter are the blades. So the blades are shown something like this, and the body is shown here. This is the symbol for a turbine flow meter. Remember, it is the inverse of the positive displacement flow meter, where the vanes are shown basically in the horizontal plane, and this is shown in the vertical plane. So for vortex flow meter, the construction is very simple. Here's the construction of a buffed body put in between. So that creates alternating vortices. The higher the flow, the higher the vortices which are created, and these are detected by the piezoelectric crystal. So generally, if you see, one of the most important thing in a vortex flow meter is this buffed body put in between. So this has been used for the P&ID symbol plus the body of it. So this is your vortex flow meter P&ID symbol. On an ultrasonic flow meter, the working is very simple. Here's the ultrasonic flow meter diagram. So here's the flow. So an ultrasonic wave will travel faster in the direction of the flow. However, when it is going in the opposite direction, it will take more time to travel. This distance traveled will increase, and such the time difference will also have an impact. So the higher the time taken for it to travel back, and the faster the time taken to travel in the direction, will indicate the increase and decrease in flow. So that is why, because the most important thing in an ultrasonic flow meter is these ultrasonic signals, it is represented as the S here. So S stands for those ultrasonic waves that have been sent. So this is the P&ID symbol for an ultrasonic flow meter. This video is part of the masterclass on Udemy called as How to Learn P&ID in a Brand New Way. I think you would find it super valuable. The link is given in the pinned comment and in the description. Till then, happy learning. Take care.